And one of the things that's important is this is why we do a lot of microgravity research. And this is hype research that's done on board the International Space Station. And while you see me having one of my favorite type days at work, the crazy hair days, I am not on board International Space Station. I'm actually on board the microgravity airplane, the Weightless Wonder, also known as the Vomit Comet. And no, I did not get sick any of my flights. And I am working to conduct microgravity research. I've had multiple flights. One of my favorites was the one that I was a principal investigator on, because it was my own research. And because it was my own idea, I'm kind of partial towards it. And in that flight, we got to investigate the exothermic welding in a reduced gravity environment. What does that mean? That means I did 12 controlled explosions on an aircraft without blowing it up. Isn't that pretty cool? No one's impressed by that?
No, it's actually pretty cool.
I think that's pretty cool. You know, the only people who can say stuff like that are terrorists, and they're not allowed to say it. So, man, getting this through security and the test conductors was a pain. They were like, you want to do what on my airplane? Amber, we're are you sure you triple checked your numbers? Because it makes people nervous. And I'm like, yeah, I'm going to be the one right up there flipping switches. But it was extremely successful, and we actually got to look at exothermic welding. When you think of exothermic welding, what we use it for here on Earth is spot welding, also known to fix train tracks. You guys have trains around here? You ever looked at the track to see how things are repaired? Yeah. So when a train track breaks, it usually gets a little gap, and if there's a gap in the tracks, well, that's bad because it can cause a train to derail. So how they fix train tracks is they'll put a little capsule around like a ceramic type container, and they'll have a controlled explosion in there, and you know, essentially liquefy all the different metals that they're filling it with. Take it off, it'll look rough and ugly, and then they'll clean it up, and voila, you have a new piece of track. It's amazing. So I was like, wow, if you can use that to spot weld holes here on Earth, what about taking that same concept and using it to fix spacecraft while they're in orbit or the space station? Because, you know, if you have the International Space Station and something the size of a quarter puts a hole in it, that can cause the space station to depressurize and could actually kill all the people on board. I mean, that's how big of a problem this type of thing is. And so we're always looking at ways to figure out what to do, how to fix it. So when you're thinking about anything you encounter in your daily life, start thinking about how would this work or apply in microgravity. Because if you do, when you go on to university, you could have a chance to submit your research ideas to NASA and fly on board the Weightless Wonder and get to do some research. For my research, I actually got to pick a team of university students to help me out. And they were undergrads. They were 18 to 22. And they got to fly on this airplane. They didn't even have degrees yet, which was really just an amazing experience for them, and it was nice for me to be able to get them to do some of my work, help me out with it. Besides that, I've also been a NASA mentor, so NASA appoints an engineer mentor for student-led research, if it's their idea instead of mine, or for if teachers submit research, because teachers can do it too. And flying in microgravity is just absolutely, absolutely amazing. It's actually the most incredible experiences of my life. And I've been very fortunate to do some pretty cool things. So, what does it feel like?
So what does it work for you?
Let's see. How about, haven't you guys been in a car? You've been driving pretty quick sometimes maybe, and you hit a little bump, and you get that little woo feeling in your tummy? Mm-hmm. Yeah, it feels nothing like that.
Oh.
So that's exactly what I thought it was going to feel like. I was waiting for the woo feeling. And you didn't get it. And you know why you don't get it? Because you get the woo feeling from the sudden change of acceleration, the up-down. These pilots are so smooth, you don't have the up-down. When they go over the top, you don't even notice. It's so smooth. And then it just comes down, and then when it comes down and starts pulling up, then you feel it. You feel two times the force of gravity, 2 G's on you, and it goes back up and does it all over again. So you get about 30-second windows of microgravity between each of it, and you fly in a science campaign about 42 different parabolas. So, it's just an incredible experience, and I heard some people actually comment with something I do like to think of as a better analog, a pool. Have we all been swimming? Who's been swimming? Okay. If you haven't, tell your parents you want to try it, find an approved guardian, and tell them what you're doing ahead of time. Don't just go scared up. Go to a pool, hold your breath, get a really big breath, go to the bottom, and then hover right above the bottom without touching anything. When you are there, you are neutrally buoyant. And neutral buoyancy is the best analog we have here on Earth to what it's like to be in microgravity. That's what we train our astronauts in the world's largest swimming pool called the Neutral Buoyancy Laboratory in Houston, Texas. Astronauts actually put on the spacesuits and scuba dive and test out all the tools underwater. We have a whole space station and space shuttle and other mock-ups underwater where we're training them to do everything. But when I'm in microgravity and I have my cape and just, you know, look awesome there, what am I doing? Am I flying?
No.
Am I floating?
No.
No.
Yeah, you are.
No. Have we seen Toy Story?
Yeah.
Toy Story 1. Does Buzz Lightyear fly?
No.
What does he do?
Falls.
He follows the style. That's exactly what's happening. I am in a state of free fall. Because as this plane is jettisoning down to Earth, I'm actually just inside the plane falling with it. And then it's going to catch me and pull up, thank goodness, and do it all over again. My favorite part of it, well, one of them, was to lay flat on the ground of the aircraft, face down, and watch when you go over the top, because the airplane's going to start falling away from you. And it's just weird because we've never seen the floor fall away from us. I mean, if we jump, we push away from the floor. So it just was a different experience to the senses. I also like to use a parabola to sit upside down on the ceiling because it was just neat to see everybody else focused and doing their work and completely upside down to me, because I thought I was right side up. And that's the neat thing with space, is everything in space is livable, workable area. Look at this classroom and think how much bigger this classroom would be if we were in microgravity. Would you guys all be sitting in those desks right there?
No.
You'd be on the ceiling, on the floor, and on the walls, finding whatever spot is comfortable and best for you to learn and work in. And that's one of the really cool stuff, is we can use all that usable space when designing and doing a lot of different experiments for microgravity. But there's a lot of different possibilities out there. But the thing that I'd like all of us to remember is this is our home. We live on planet Earth, and you know what? It's not just a planet, it's a spaceship. We're already on a spaceship in orbit around the sun, going through the universe. I mean, this is just fantastic. And even though we build other little spacecrafts that can take people up, a couple people, this is the one we're all on it together. So whatever it is that you feel is worth your time, talents, and abilities, work hard and apply everything you have to offer to things that better this place for all of us. Whatever capacity that may be, and do stuff, do what you love, you know, and go pursue that, because you really should, your job should be fun. And you should really never truly have to work a day in your life. You should get paid to do your hobby. And just being able to make the place a better planet for all of us by contributing everything and just having a blast doing it. Because life's too short to do anything otherwise. But if you do like space, especially if you like the engineering and science side, there's some really fun opportunities, whether it's doing microgravity research, whether it's helping to design some of the new spacecrafts or spacesuits or landers, whether it's using spin-off technologies that we've invented for space to help improve life here on Earth, or even help with some of the commercial partners that are going to be going just to the space station and staying in low Earth orbit. I mean, endless possibilities. And even if you don't like the science and engineering, we need all types in the space program. So if you like it, there's always space for you. And yes, that was a pun intended. So before, I thank you all for your attention. I would like to show you a short little video clip.
From Kennedy Space Center in Florida at T-minus 3 hours and holding. And we're now in the final 5 hours of the countdown.
Thank you.
Do astronauts get paid?
How much do astronauts get paid? That's a great question. You can look it up online. all government employee salaries are posted online, so you can see. Astronauts, they don't get paid great. You do it for love of the job. So really, if you want to go into aerospace and make the big bucks, I can't believe I'm admitting this, go to the defense side of things. Defense jobs pay a lot higher than civil space sector, so if you're doing like the missiles or the DARPA stuff or the space research technology, those are the better paying jobs. The starting salary in space flight for say an entry level engineer, obviously depending on the state, but starting salary say at like Johnson Space Center in Texas or Kennedy Space Center in Florida is about $50,000. So I mean that's right after college is not bad at all. You can definitely get things paid off. California gets paid usually a little higher because of higher cost of living, so does Colorado. But yeah, so it just depends on what projects you work on and stuff like that.